So you've decided that you want to branch out from NASCAR and try watching other forms of racing. Let me start by congratulating you for having opened your mind to the wider world of racing. Well, you settled on IndyCar, but you have no idea what that is or how it works, and the terminology they're using makes no sense to you. But you come to the right place. This is the NASCAR Fan's Guide to IndyCar. First off, we're going to keep this very simple. We're not going to delve too deep, we're just going to give you enough information to have a basic understanding of IndyCar. You can leave this video knowing you can confidently watch an IndyCar race and understand what's happening. Fortunately for you, you're a NASCAR fan, and you already know things about racing, so we don't need to explain the basic racing terms. IndyCar is an American open-wheel racing series. It's literally referred to as open-wheel because the wheels are on the outside of the car. Open. The NTT IndyCar series has taken many forms over the years, from USAC to the PPG IndyCar series, CART, the IRL, Champ Car, etc. But we won't get into all those confusing specifics. Right now, all you need to know is that it's called the NTT IndyCar series. The cars. As previously mentioned, IndyCars are open wheel, similar to Formula One in that way. The chassis that the teams use are made by an Italian company called Dallara, and they're spec. This means that everyone uses the exact same chassis, and modifications to them are extremely limited. There are two engine providers or manufacturers, Chevrolet and Honda. IndyCar is a diverse series and uses both ovals and road courses, so there's a different aero kit on the cars for certain races. You'll notice a slight difference in the look of an oval car to a road course car. Starting in 2020, IndyCar also introduced the aero screen, or the windshield you see here. The jury's still out on it, but if it helps protect the driver, I'm game for anything that improves safety. One other important thing to mention is the push to pass. At road course and street circuit races, IndyCars have a feature called push to pass. It's triggered by a button on the steering wheel and gives the driver a small boost of horsepower to help them pass a competitor. But it isn't unlimited. They have a set number of seconds to use throughout the race, so its use actually becomes very strategic. Some people think that this is gimmicky and stupid, but they're wrong. It's awesome. Oh, we should also mention the tires. IndyCar uses Firestone tires, and there are two different compounds to choose from. A red compound, discernible by the red stripe on the tire, and a black compound. The reds are softer and supply more grip, but they also wear out very fast. Each team must use both compounds during a race, which leads to some interesting strategies. Do you take the faster soft tires early, or do you save them for later? The tracks. We already touched on it, but IndyCar races at ovals, road courses, and temporary street circuits. There are only 5 ovals on the schedule, so they've become a minority in recent years. IndyCar visits quite a few tracks that you may recognize from NASCAR, such as Texas Motor Speedway, Road America, Gateway, and Iowa Speedway. They also visit a street circuit in Toronto, Barber Motorsports Park in Alabama, and Laguna Seca, to name a few. The teams. You'll recognize a couple teams from NASCAR in the IndyCar rigs. Both Team Penske and Chip Ganassi Racing compete in IndyCar and are among the most successful teams. In fact, Penske has won 3 of the last 4 driver championships. Other notable teams include Andretti Autosport, Ray Hall Letterman Lanigan Racing, yes, that Letterman, and Aero McLaren SP, operated by the same group that run the McLaren Formula One team. There are a bunch of other teams, but we're trying to keep this short for you. The drivers. Like NASCAR, IndyCar has a wide variety of drivers to root for. But unlike NASCAR, you'll find a lot of international diversity in IndyCar. Drivers come from all over the world to compete in IndyCar. New Zealand driver Scott Dixon is the elder statesman and kind of the Jimmy Johnson of IndyCar. He has 5 championships to his name. French driver Simon Pagenaud won the 2019 Indy 500 and is a former series champion. He also has a famous dog. If you're looking for Americans to root for, both Alexander Rossi and Joseph Newgarden are great options. Newgarden has 2 championships as a driver for Team Penske, and Rossi won the Indy 500 as a rookie in 2016. If you're looking for underdogs, British driver Jack Harvey is a great option. He drives for Meyer Shank Racing. Or you can go with fan favorite Connor Daly. Finally, if you're looking to root for a young gun, look no farther than Colton Herta. He's the youngest winner in IndyCar history and still has time to be the youngest Indy 500 winner of all time. The races. Well, first we'll touch on qualifying. We wanted to briefly touch on it because it's a little different than NASCAR. It uses a multi-segment group qualifying format. Drivers are eliminated in each segment until 6 are remaining. They're referred to as the Fast 6, because apparently coming up with a better name was too difficult. And then those 6 drivers shoot it out for the pole. Like NASCAR, IndyCar races are a predetermined number of laps, But there are no stages because, well, you know, stages are... no comment. Pit stops are similar to NASCAR, but the team can have four tire changers sitting in the box ready to go, and the tires only have one lug nut in the center, so the stops are much faster. The pit crew members on IndyCar teams often have other jobs, such as a mechanic or an engineer, while NASCAR has become a lot more specialized. Oh yeah, an IndyCar does race in the rain on road and street courses, but like in NASCAR, they do not race in the rain on oval tracks. The championship. Unlike NASCAR, IndyCar uses a full season championship format. Simple, to the point, no gimmicks, no win and you're in playoffs, it's just the way motor racing was meant to be. But I guess they do actually have one gimmick, double points races. Certain races on the calendar pay double points, you just get twice as many points as usual for your finishing position. Traditionally, the Indy 500 and the season finale pay double points, but sometimes they change it up. Other than that, it's just your regular run-of-the-mill championship. The terminology. If you only pay attention to one segment, let it be this one. IndyCar uses very different terms for things than NASCAR does. In fact, the more different types of racing you'll watch, you'll learn that NASCAR is actually kind of the weird series. Terms in NASCAR don't really get used in other series, so it's actually kind of cool that NASCAR has their own language. So here we go. The car isn't loose, it has oversteer. And the car isn't tight, it's just understeering too much. The draft is called the toe. You're getting a great toe off the car in front of you. Your spoiler is actually a rear wing. Your windshield is called an aero screen, which is way cooler. Shocks are called dampers. You don't have a crew chief. You have a strategist. Paint schemes are called liveries. In fact, they're called liveries in every other form of auto racing. They don't bring your car to the track in a hauler, they bring it in a transporter. And you don't hang out in the garage, you hang out in the paddock. There are a bunch more, but those are really the basic ones that you need to know to understand what they're talking about. But don't worry, the IndyCar broadcast team does a great job explaining things as we go, so you're gonna be just fine. Well, there you have it, folks. A simple NASCAR fan's guide to IndyCar. If you enjoyed this video, please leave a comment, like, and subscribe to all of our motorsports content, and also check out one of our other videos, like this one about how Joey Logano ruined Peyton Sellers' future with one dumb move.